Yes, class 10, as we were studying the chapter Footprints Without Feet. So we have come to know about Griffin, the scientist who has invented some rare drugs and after swallowing which he has turned out to be invisible. So invisible, of course, it is a great formula invented by him. But of course, on the other side, it was a problem for him. Why it was a problem? Yes, in order to be visible, he has to remove his clothes. This is one thing. And moreover, that was the time of mid-winter, mid-November, when extreme north wind was blowing and the entire London, it was covered, or entire London streets, they were covered with snow. So in such kind of weather, it was really difficult for him to move without clothes. So he has to save himself. So in order to protect one day, so where he has gone? He has gone to a store, okay, in which he has taken refuge just for a night. But ultimately, because the assistants, they have arrived at early dawn, and he has not wake up. So ultimately, he has to run away from there. Then afterwards, where he has gone? Then he thought that he should cover his body in a manner so that the other people would not come to know about his invisibility. So he has gone to Drury Lane. Where he has gone? Drury Lane. Why Drury Lane? Because there were number of shops which were selling the theatrical equipments or the things, okay, with which he can cover up his face. So there he has gone in a perfect shop where he has found all the things so that he can cover his face, because he has to cover the hollow space above his shoulders and below his hat. That was his face. So he has covered with bandages his forehead, put a false nose, put side bushy whiskers, and ultimately we also wear, in order to cover those hollows of the eyes, he has covered them up with glasses. So finally he has gone to Iping. So in Iping, where he has taken refuge? Where he has taken refuge? He has taken refuge in where? Mr. and Mrs. Hall's Inn. Okay. He has rented how many rooms? He has rented there? Two rooms. Two rooms he has rented there. And for that, the money he has paid in advance. But he has also made an excuse that he did not have any ready cash with him. So as soon as the check would arrive, he will pay for his the rent for the rest of the months. Then afterwards, as he arrived there, as he was short of money, a curious incident happens in the clergyman's desk, or in the clergyman's study, sorry. What was that curious episode there? That early in the morning, the clergyman, he has listened some voices in the study. Mr. and the clergyman and his wife, they have gone to the study in order to locate who is drawing the money out of the desk drawer, as they have heard the chinking sound of the money. But what happened when they have opened the door with the poker, they flung open the door. So what happened? Nobody was to be seen there. As nobody was there, they have looked behind the curtains, behind the door also, and above the chimney too. But nowhere was to be seen. Who was he? It was invisible man. This also led many people talking in the town of the strange incident that has happened. And clergyman, he has come out with a comment that it was an extraordinary affair, right? Then afterwards, similar these kind of strange incidents happened, that one day when Mrs. Hall, she found the door open of Griffin's room. So it was very strange for her, because otherwise most of the time the scientist is always confined to his room, never talking to anybody, and is never allowing anybody to enter his room. So finally, when she found that the room was open, she wanted to investigate actually what this scientist is doing. So she has looked into the room along with Mr. Halls, her husband. She has noticed that the bed covers, they were quite cold. It means that Griffin had not been there for quite some time. So suddenly what happened? The hat from the bedpost came alive and it dashed upon the face of Mrs. Holmes. Later on, the chair flung open, or the chair became alive. It flung in the air and pushed or drove away Mrs. Hall as well as her husband out of the room. Then what was the effect of all this incident upon Mrs. Hall? She turned to be hysteric. She was on the verge to be swooned away. Swooned away means unconscious. And finally, they have sent for the constable. Next, we are going to continue. Now, the constable has come to know from the people that now he has to catch a man without any head. Why? Because it was only clothes that were invisible, but not the rest of the rest part of the body, that is his head. So finally, what he has to do, finally, because Griffin was short-tempered, he got angry very easily. So when Mrs. Hall said, actually, I want to know what you were doing all the day through. So he said, let me tell you. So what he did, he started taking off his clothes and throwing it onto the ground, making himself invisible. So next we are going to read here from page number 30. So you don't understand who or what I am? Very well, I'll show you. He said, if you don't know who I am, let me show you who I am. Suddenly, he threw off all bandages, whiskers, spectacles, and even nose. It took him only a minute to do this. The horrified people in the bar found themselves staring at a headless man. So what he did, he took off his bandages, his glasses, his nose, his whiskers, thrown onto the ground. Then, as he was wearing the clothes, so he has turned out into a headless man, which was very horrible scene for the people who are standing around. They were surprised to see such a man without a head, as they have never witnessed such a man without a head. So Mr. Jeffers, the constable, has now arrived and was quite surprised to find that he had to arrest a man without a head. So Mr. Jeffers, who has also come there, who was Mr. Jeffers? He was the village constable. Okay. He was the village constable. He has also arrived there. And when he came to know that he has to find a man, he has to arrest a man without head, that was really impossible for him. But Jeffers was not easily prevented from doing his duty. But Mr. Jeffers, who was sincere towards his duty, he was not at all prevented from doing all this kind of duty. Why? Because he was committed that if he has come to catch a man without a head, he would definitely do so. Then, if a magistrate's warrant ordered a person's arrest, then the person had to be arrested with or without his head. So what he said, if magistrate has given the order that I have to arrest a man, I have to arrest a man, whether it is with head or without head. I have to, he said. So there followed a remarkable scene as the policeman tried to get hold of a man who was becoming more and more invisible as he threw off one garment after another. So then after a remarkable scene happened there, as now the police as well as the people, they have witnessed a man who is turning out to be invisible. As soon as he throwing off his clothes, he is turning out to be invisible. First of all, the upper part, then the lower part also turned out to be invisible. And finally, it was complete a vacant space. Nobody was able to look at the person and how to catch him. So finally, a shot flew into the air and the constable found himself struggling with someone he could not see at all. So now he removed the shirt. Then he found that what to find. Okay, Mr. Jeffers was struggling what to find, because nowhere he is to be seen. He should go to this side, to that side, where he should go in order to catch that man, because he is not able to see that man. But that was sure he was present at that very moment in that area. So some people tried to help him, but found themselves hit by blows that seemed to come from nowhere. Some people, they also tried, but what he was doing, he was giving blows to people and people were just looking from where it is coming. So in the end, Jeffers was knocked unconscious as he made a last attempt to hold on to the unseen scientist. Finally, in the end, Mr. Jeffers, he was knocked unconscious. He was so tired of catching this man that he turned out to be unconscious, because now he is struggling to catch an invisible man, which is not at all possible for him. There were nervous, excited cries of "Hold him, hold him!" But this was easier said than done. So many people were crying, "Hold him!" But it was easy to catch such a man. No, it was really not easy to catch such a man, as he was not to be seen. And Griffin had shaken himself free, and no one knew where to lay hands on him. And finally, once again, Griffin was free, and nobody knew where to find him. So it is this point in this chapter or in this novel when his, you can say, invisibility, it became public. It means that people come to know that this is the invisible man. And earlier, whatever the stories they were listening around, that there is an invisible man who is doing all this, nobody was believing. Okay? So ultimately here his invisibility turned out to be public, and police also came to know that he was an invisible man who is committing various crimes, theft, robbery, and ultimately police was after his life. And in the end, finally, he was caught and he was shot dead in the end of the novel, right? This was just an excerpt from this novel I told you, okay, Invisible Man. So let us start the question answers, okay? So the first question is, Griffin was rather a lawless person, comment. How can you say that Griffin was a lawless person? Yes, who will give the answer? How Griffin Madhav is a lawless person? Yes. So Griffin, who has invented the secret formula that by swallowing certain rare drugs, he turned out to be, or he became invisible. Though he was a brilliant scientist, but he was of course a lawless person. As at the onset of the story, he has set his own house on fire as he hated his landlord, right? Then afterwards, he is breaking laws now and then. He is a cheater. He is a liar also. Yes, stealing money. When he has come to Iping, first of all, the first lie that he has made was that he is waiting for his check. And as soon as the check would arrive, he would make his rest of the payment. Then afterwards, yes, moreover, he was a lawless person. He was making an excuse that he has covered his forehead with bandages because he has met with an accident and ultimately his face was damaged. Later on, when he has committed theft or robbery at clergyman's study, that was again a great example of his lawlessness, that he was not at all a law-abiding man who is breaking the rules every now and then. And finally, how he behaved with Mr. Jeffers, the constable, and made him or knocked him down to unconsciousness. This all from this chapter are the examples which reveal that he was a lawless person. Yes, I told, he knocked him down to unconsciousness. Okay, right? So ultimately he was a lawless person. Next, how would you assess Griffin as a scientist? How would you assess Griffin as a scientist? Huh? Means assess means what do you think about him? Or do you think that he was a real scientist? But he has not done so. Okay, but he has not done so. So if we see as a scientist, we cannot say that he is a perfect example of a scientist. Because as a scientist, if you have brain, you must have used it wisely. He has brain. He had invented the formula to be invisible. Okay, that by swallowing certain rare drugs, he turned out to be invisible. But ultimately, he had not used it wisely. He has not used this formula for the benefit of mankind. Rather, he has used it for the fulfillment of his selfish motives. Okay, He wanted to steal money. He wanted to take revenge from his landowner. And he has committed number of crimes for which the police is after him. He is always evading the arrest or he is always evading the police. Ultimately, why the police is after him? It was just because of his lawless nature. So as a scientist, we cannot speak good of him or that great of him, as he was not such a great scientist. Because as a human being, he was a very bad human being. Right? So, next is, would you like to become invisible and what advantages and disadvantages do you foresee if you did? Yes. Do you like to be scientist? Yes. And to be invisible? Yes. So, what advantages do you see in this? Huh? Be a part of an army, right? Then? How you can help others? Again, stealing. Stealing is not a good quality. You can earn in various ways. You can tame, you can sort many matters out. Okay, and to help the government in sorting out many matters. Yes, of course, in arresting criminals, solving many cases, right? Okay. Huh? Of course, you can fetch money. Are there forces around us that are invisible? For example, magnetism. Are there aspects of matter that are invisible or not visible to the naked eye? And what would the world be like if you could see such forces on such aspects of matter? This is again based upon your creative imagination, what you think, right? So next is, what makes glass or water transparent? This is for your scientific reasoning. Okay, what makes it transparent? That is, when light is, you can say, split into seven colors, it is supposed to be visible. Okay. Is the color which we see. It means no color is reflected back.
I mean, seven colors mixed together in a spectrum, only light, five colors.
Chalo, that better you will discuss with your science teacher also, right? Okay. And let me know also. Okay. So as only two main questions are there that you have to write in notebook, the first two, I'm discussing with you some extra questions that you have to write down in your notebooks. So note down side by side. The first one is, what did Griffin do to escape after setting the house on fire? What did Griffin do to escape after setting his house on fire? Okay, so what did he do? So I'm stopping the sharing with you. So it is visible on your screens. The first question, what did Griffin do to escape after setting out his house on fire? So what did he do? When he was set out his house on fire, then he has turned out to be a wanderer. He did not have clothes to protect himself. Moreover, he was moving in the streets of London. But it was not, or the weather was not bearable. So where he has gone? He has taken a temporary refuge in a store. Okay, in order to protect himself and to find some cozy clothes there. Okay, this is how. Okay. Next is, what happened when Griffin did not wake up on time? What happened? What happened? Yes, Peter. This is what you are getting in test. we are sending MCQs. It is just because of this reason. Otherwise, we have opted for subjective and objective ones. 1 week you will have some objective, 1 week you will have subjective. Now you are watching that we have changed it to objective only. This is the reason. Okay. Whenever test is there, it is of course in objective only. We are not taking it in subjective form. Okay, of course, we will have the questionnaire in the class only. Right? Okay, but if you want to attempt objective ones, you should have deep knowledge of the chapter. For example, if somebody will ask you, who was Mr. Jefferson? You people will see each other's face. Yes, Mr. Jefferson, Mr. Jefferson. Okay, what is the name of Wanda Pontrowski's father? These small, small details. It was? What? No? Jan Pontrowski. Jan Pontrowski. Right? So, if you have the knowledge how to write on subjective, you will automatically be able to attempt the objective. Right? So, here the first question. The next question is, what happened when people did the wake up on time? What happened when Griffin didn't wake up on time? Note down these questions, please, in your notebooks. What happened when Griffin wake up on time? When Griffin didn't wake up on time, the store assistant boys or the assistant boys, they have arrived on the scene early in the early dawn, and ultimately Griffin found himself to be unable to escape from that store. And finally, what he did? He has to remove his clothes in order to escape the cats. Okay, so that they won't be able to catch. Now write down next question. Why did Griffin go to Drury Lane? Who's that making noise? Stop now. Why did Griffin go to Drury Lane? Why he has gone to Drury Lane? Why did Griffin go to Drury Lane? Yes, because after becoming invisible, it was difficult for him to conceal the hollow space above his shoulders as well as below his hat. So he wanted some theatrical things so that he could cover his face with, and for that he has found that the Drury Lane is a perfect place, as there are a number of shops related to theater accessories, and this is the reason why he has gone there, so that he can get some good things to cover his face. And what did he find in the Drury Lane? False nose. He has covered his forehead with bandages, nose with then goggles, okay, and then bushy whiskers and a hat. He was already here. He has got it from the previous tool, right? Explain the curious episode at clergyman study. Explain the curious episode at clergyman's study. What was the previous episode? I have explained number of times. Now you people will explain me. Write at least 5 questions in notebook. Writing MCQ is not an easy task. That you think. For reading, you have the complete knowledge. You should have the complete knowledge. Okay. Subjective. If you have subjective knowledge, only then you will be able to do objective. Okay. Deep knowledge will make everything go easier. This is the This is the reason why we are doing. Yes, curious episode at clergyman's desk. 1 minute. For that now, for MCQs, you should have the knowledge, complete knowledge of the various phrases used in the chapter, various meanings also. Anything can be asked in any manner. Okay? Right? So, don't skip some of the students. They are in the habit of reading the summary. That will completely be against it. Won't be helpful at any cost. Okay? Go through the chapter deeply. So, coming up to this. Yes, clergyman study. What happened? Yes. Very good. Nobody there. Then he found nobody, but still the chinking of the coins was there. They came to know that somebody is stealing the money from the desk drawer, but they were unable to catch that man. Finally, they looked for the man behind the door, behind the curtains and above the chimney too, but they were unable to find the man. Finally, the clergyman, he came out with just single, you can say, a comment that it was an extraordinary affair, as they were unable to figure out this entire matter, that who was there, who was stealing the money, but still the money was missing. Right? Yeah, of course. Okay, and they thought that it is some, you can say, a supernatural force that was committing all this. Okay, it can be a ghost, and some people were also suggesting, neighbors, that it was a haunted house. Okay? Yes. Which light? If I will... That is attached with this. On. It's still on. Okay, right. Now you are able to see? Then why you haven't spoken at the starting? You were just... Okay. Now it is visible to you. Okay, fine. Okay, now write down next last question. Yes, why were Mr. and Mrs. Hall surprised? Mr. and Mrs. Hall surprised to see the door wide open. Why they were surprised to see the door wide open? Yes.
Because the door was closed and the scientist would not allow anyone to enter
this. And he has clearly mentioned that he has come to live at this place just for the sake of solitude. And when she found the door open, she turned out to be inquisitive. She wanted to know everything about the scientist, that what he is doing throughout the day in this locked room. And finally, what happened? She went into the room, and then the next question will appear, that what happened when Mr. and Mrs. Hall went into the scientist's room. That we will discuss afterwards. Okay? So many funny incidents. See, the greatness of the writer who has written this novel, he has added humor. He has added, tragedy, of course. Okay, and how he has twisted the image of the scientist. He's a great one, but later on he has turned out to be a criminal. Okay, and let me tell you that all these movies, which are the famous ones, they are always inspired from the books. They read the books and ultimately they are picturized. Okay, so ultimately the great lesson what we have come to learn is be a good reader. Okay, be a great reader, voracious reader.
We have come to learn that whenever someone receives power, he turns into a criminal.
He turns into a criminal. It is not a cup of tea of everyone to handle power. Okay, it is not a cup of tea of everyone. How to handle power? And this is what has happened. He has got the power, and finally he has misused it, and ultimately everything bad ends in a bad way. Ultimately, he was dead at that time. Okay, that's all for today. I'm getting the attendance. So that's all for today. In the next one, we will start. And yes, you are having your data interpretation. Earlier, we have done data interpretation about the graph. According to the new one, it is, I think, of the person. Especially on the person. See, but what is important for you people is that like you will get an exam. Let me make sure whether it is for 9th or 10th. I'm a little bit confused. Okay? That you will get, for example, write paragraph on Mother Teresa. It means you must have the knowledge. Okay, such kinds are also given. I have seen somewhere. 1 minute. That's all for today. Tomorrow we will continue.